Hey guys, today I'll show a short tutorial on how to find the RPM of objects. So I have a bunch of fidget spinners here. So this one, and then this is one of them.
And I'll also use the ceiling fan as an example of finding the RPM.
So basically what I have to record is slow motion footage of spinning an object. So I'll be spinning this fidget spinner. Yeah, that those few seconds will be enough for that. Now take that footage and edit the slow motion video and see, basically we want a small portion where we can see the object spinning at its full speed. Okay, so now we do that and we make sure that we set the slow motion also to the full, and then we save the footage. Now copy this exported video to your computer.
Okay, so I am at my video editor right now. It is Movie Maker. What I basically want to do is, I want to get the duration it takes to spin like from here to just take one full round. So then I'll just begin like this. Then it is here, right? So there it almost takes a full round. Okay, so if I see the length, it is 0.43 seconds. So let me just do some calculations quick. So if I say that it takes 0.43 seconds to spin at slow motion, then if I do divided by 8, then 8, see, basically I'm slowing the video 8 times. That's the slow motion part. And then I get this duration. So it means the actual duration, like one rotation will take these many seconds. So and then if I do copy this and 1 by that thing, then I get this is rotations per second, meaning in 1 second these many rotations can happen. Basically you're inversing the fraction. So this is 1 second, right? To convert second to minute, you multiply it by 60. So you get around 1100 RPM, that fidget spinner which was spinning. That's an approximate value, you know, it varies depending on so many factors. Like say, imagine the thing is spinning faster than what your camera can record, so the RPM might be very less. Okay, the fan is running at its max speed right now. So I'm recording it with slow motion, and I will edit the footage and show you later what's happening. So I'm also using my flash in case the lights flicker and the video doesn't come out to be proper. Okay, so this is my slow motion version of the fan. Okay, let's assume we start from here in this place. And then... yeah, around there it finishes a full rotation. So it's 1.73 seconds in slow motion. So if it is 1.73 seconds in slow motion, then if I do divided by 8, then I get the actual time. So in these many seconds, it will finish one rotation. So if I do the inverse of this fraction, then basically I get 4.6 rotations in 1 second. Then if I do into 60, I get 275 rotations per minute, that is RPM. So this ceiling fan is at around 275 RPM at maximum. Okay, so I have made a quick formula reference. T is this thing, like the duration of one rotation in slow motion. So when I recorded the slow motion video, let's take 0.43. I think it was a fidget spinner, right? Yeah. So when I measure the duration of one rotation, when I record in slow motion, it was 0.43 seconds. And the slow motion rate, that was set as 8 times slow. The speed of slow motion in the sense like how slow it is recording. So that's 8 times slow. So I get the approximate RPM as 1100. Okay, see, this time is like slowed down, right? And if I divide it by 8, it means I get the time taken for one rotation in the actual real time speed. So it means I get how many seconds it takes to do one rotation. If I do the inverse of the fraction, it means I get the number of rotations that can be done in 1 second. As this is in seconds, if I multiply it with 60, I get rotations per minute. If I do the inverse of this, the R will go to numerator. So it will become R by T into 60. 60 I can multiply, so it will be 60 R by T. R is the rate, 8 times slow, and T is the duration of one rotation in slow motion. So you can try using this simple formula. If you're too lazy to do the calculations or you just don't understand this part, I'll put a link in my description to this file so that you can download and modify the values and get your RPM approximately.